Hello everybody and welcome back to the XsivGaming channel and Farm Simulator 2017. This is our Let's Play series on Chellington Farm. And today we are up to episode 31. Making some good progress. So if you could quickly drop us a like on this video, it'd be much appreciated. And of course if you are new to the channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. So here we go. Episode 31. What are we up to today? So we're here at the farm, just picking up the Marshall trailer. And what we're going to be doing today is a whole crop harvest. So what is a whole crop harvest? It is where you are taking the whole crop, shredding it up, and turning it into a chaff. That chaff is then dumped into a pit, and you cover it up, and you turn it into silage. So a whole crop harvest. The plan for today. I'm going to overtake this slow coach before we have a crash. So where are we doing this whole crop harvest? I hear you say. Well, down at field 11. Planted the next to the road, planted the poplars. We have got a crop of canola, I believe it is. Here it's field 11. As you can see, our poplars are growing nicely. Beyond that is the canola. So how do we whole crop harvest? Well, first things first, we're going to need a special harvester and header. This is called a forage harvester, which we've got purchased here. So here we go. We've purchased the New Holland FR850, which is the forage harvester. Again, it is a beast of a machine. That's where it will eat everything in, it processes it, and then it spits out the pipe. But to do any foraging and turning it into chaff with this, we need special kind of headers. So we'll start with this one. This is the effectively it's like a lawnmower. It will literally strip everything up. Like a crop, cereals, it will pull the grass up, etc. Okay, so the next one all spreads out, and it is a header that will cut your corn, for example, and again pull it into the machine and spit it out as chaff. Now this one is for the poplars. So once the poplar's grown, it will pull it into there, cut it at the bottom, and of course feed it through the machine. But instead of turning it into chaff, it will turn it into the wood chips. So even though we don't need this one now, we've actually purchased this one as we was purchasing the necessary equipment. We don't need the corn one at the moment, but we will use it at another point. So today we are using the lawnmower type one. So we'll jump in, we'll get started up. The machine is a bit noisy, so apologies if the sound is not correct. So all we do is, same as a normal house, to pull up, connect it all up. See if we can lift it up anymore, but no, we can't. So anyway, here we go. Head on over to our field. So this will actually cut the grass and pull it through his chaff as well. We don't want to do that. We are cutting this canola up here. So you get the pipe out, and what it will do is it will lock onto any nearby trailers. You can turn the harvester on. Put it onto a worker. He's not going to move anywhere just yet because there's no nearby trailer to load. Of course, we're going to run back to the Fendt tractor with the Marshall trailer. You can see our poplar's growing very nicely there. So start that back up. It's the Fendt 939 Vario. Trailer back. All we need to do is pull alongside, we'll see the pipe automatically lock off the trailer, and hopefully he's going to start moving. No, he's gone home. Okay, so start the engine on, turn the harvester on, we'll just pull the board, and as you see, it starts spitting out the chaff. Get the worker on, we're going to jump back into the tractor and carry along with him. The only problem I can see at the moment is we're going to have to drive onto the crop to reach. I think he's reaching for the moment. Okay, so what I'm trying to do is see if it works. We're going to drive up the centre behind him. Finish driving through trees. It's across here. Hopefully we can keep up with him. Hitting him. There we are actually collecting the chaff. We can now run right alongside him. Open the chaff. excuse the coffee interruptions there. I thought I was getting over it, but unfortunately not. Whole point of Wholecrop harvesting is to get a good amount of chaff built up. All that chaff can go be fermented into silage. Really, on one of our previous episodes, we did silage. We actually used grass, so freshly cut grass from the lawnmower, picked it all up and got it took off some cows, put it here and fermented it that way. That gave us silage. So this is, if you like, a second way of getting silage. Actually hook some selected trailers up to the back of the forage harvester for that to put. Of course, if you're trying to run packs of forwards, silage bit, then you're going to need trailer. So again, once our trailer's full, which we're fast approaching, the harvester will just stop. And then we can go off and empty. The worker will actually stay. Until we come back. There we go. So yeah, we're nearly full. Harvester's just stopped, but he is still running because he's waiting for a trailer now. So what we're going to do is just take this off to the silage bit at the biogas plant. Get back onto the main road. And where is the biogas plant? Yeah, it's at Chellington stores. So everything is pretty much at Chellington stores. On the left here, and as you can see, already started putting some chaff in here. So what you need to do is get your trailer on, hit the unload anywhere button, chip in there, unload here. What it will do is simply trap the chaff out, hopefully not get your trailer stuck. That's that. Once you've got all your chaff in here, what you need to do is keep driving over it and compact it down. So we was at 100% with this. Putting that in there, it's actually reduced it now. We've got to just compact down what we've got. Now I've got my trailer stuck. So that's back down to 100% compacted. We have 238,365 litres of chaff in there at the moment. That's going to be a good amount of silage once we're ready. So we'll head back to the field, finish and load in. The road seemed quiet. Usually when we come down here it's loads of traffic. Yeah, we'll just head back to the field. Get another trailer full. Pull alongside the harvester, they'll automatically detect an empty trailer, the pipe lock locks off. We'll come back when the trailer's nearly full again. Okay, so welcome back. We've got another full trailer ready. completely full now. He stopped again. We're heading back off to the BGA. Quickest way to contract by steering on the chaff. So keep bouncing forward but side to side at the same time if you can. See, it'll pack it down quicker. In, so if you want us to spend absolute ages filling up all five pits, be my guest. Once again, back to field, and we should get another load done. See you in a tick. So welcome back again. As you can see, we're nearly actually finished this build. This is going to be the last trailer load that we take. Got some tidying up to do afterwards, but camera. This is Wholecrop harvesting. Hopefully that's the information in this video will be helpful. And if you can just click and drop us a like, it'd be much appreciated. I do enjoy making these videos, but it is nice to see the appreciation. be the last load anyway. Take this off to the bike as well. Get it put into the side of the pit. Yeah. It will compact it down, etc. Again. This one could just give it a twerk at the time being. There. Did I shut that off? Put the pipe back in for the time being. So that's that all shut off. Take this off to the fire gas pump, it's literally just over there. Obviously I've got the river between us and the fire gas pump, so we have to use the road. Take off. So again, hit the upload button. Obviously you can spread it out even better. Okay, so what I'm gonna do. So we can get this all compacted down a bit quick. Maybe not get ourselves stuck. Looks like exactly what we've done. Yeah, we're moving slowly. Just driving up and down, which I have to compact it. It's obviously a cheaper option. There are other options there. You can buy levelers, some mods that you can download, rollers, etc. Trying to make money, then the easiest thing to do is just drive up and down. So we're at 97%. Back out. shut the engine off for a moment. So this is all of our chaff, as you can see it's quite hilly in the middle here. But we have 303,507 litres in there. So once you've got it all compacted down, what we need to do is flement it. So we blanket the silo, and that puts this mesh down, plasticky type mesh, covers everything up like so. And at the moment it is 1% flamented. We'll come back maybe in another episode when that's all done. But for today, that is going to be it. So hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, if you can just drop us a quick like. If you are new to the channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. And we shall see you in the next episode. Thank you very much for watching, and bye for now.